What's up everybody, this is Danny. This is the brand new LG V30. I've been using this for about a week now, and I think this could be the phone that everyone has been waiting for. Let me tell you my top 5 favorite features of the V30, and I'll give you a little mini review along the way. My first favorite feature is the all new design. No longer do you get a metal phone like you did with the V20. Unfortunately, the removable battery is gone too, and the design and size is pretty close to the Galaxy S8 Plus. The trademark of the V20 with the physical secondary display is now gone. It's replaced by the floating display, and even though I'll miss the unobtrusive notifications, I'm okay with this for a better form factor. The phone feels premium with the glass back, but you know I'll probably put a skin on it like I did with the Galaxy S8. It is much lighter than you think it might be, but I really like the hardware, and this thing is feature packed. It is Gorilla Glass 5 on the front and back, and it carries over the mil-spec A10G rating from the V20. That glass pack means that you have support for both PMA and Qi wireless charging, which is awesome in my opinion. This build also allows it to be IP68 water resistant, so water is no problem for the V30. Quick hardware tour, there's a USB-C port at the bottom with quick charging, and there's also a single speaker. Volume rockers on the side. There's a SIM tray on the other side with a microSD card slot to enhance that 64GB of onboard storage. Yes, there's a headphone jack at the top, and there's a rear-mounted fingerprint scanner, which is super fast. LG pretty much started the rear fingerprint placement, and it's one of my favorites, but the best way to unlock is facial recognition. This thing is ridiculously fast, and I personally think it's much faster and more accurate than the Samsung phones. You can also unlock your phone with a phrase or a word, and that's cool, but I wouldn't use it for security reasons. The second feature is this beautiful 6-inch OLED display with an 18:9 aspect ratio. It is incredibly sharp, and since it's an OLED display, the colors pop, the contrast is insane, and watching content on this is really nice. The UI is really responsive with the Snapdragon 835 processor and 4GB of RAM. It's smoother than other phones that I've tested lately, very smooth frame rates, makes the other phones feel kind of choppy when I go back to them. The curves are gentle on the sides, so it feels natural when you're scrolling. The bezels are minimal. The display is also nice and bright, so viewable in outdoors. That's very important. There's only one thing that I can say about the display is that there is some color shifting when tilting the phone at extreme angles. It might not show up on video well, and it's not a deal breaker at all. I just thought I would point it out. The third feature is the dual camera setup. This could arguably be the best thing about this phone. The main sensor is the brightest that we've seen on a mobile camera so far. It's a 16-megapixel f1.6 aperture lens with optical image stabilization, and the secondary wide-angle camera now also gets better with the f1.9 aperture, so low light on the wide-angle is improved. Also, the barrel distortion has been significantly improved, so that GoPro look is gone. So much better, but you still keep that super wide-angle, and it is just incredible in shots like this. You don't know how much you need this until you actually have it and you capture the whole scene. I absolutely love it. The pictures so far from the camera have been great. Nice dynamic range, good colors. The over-sharpening is still there, and some people like this since the images look a little bit sharper, but that's just personal preference. But I don't think you'll be disappointed. The fourth feature has to do with the software, focusing on the camera software, of course. Android 7.1.2 looks pretty similar to other LG phones, so we won't focus on that, but I do want to focus on the camera software. Of course, the V30 still has the best manual mode for photo and video. Having full control of your video is a big deal for creators that produce videos from their smartphones, but the V30 takes it to the next level. Now the V30 lets you shoot in a log profile for the best flexibility in post-processing. You get a pretty flat image, but you can use the display LUT to see what it could look like after post-processing. You don't have to be a pro though, you can just go into the new Cine Video mode. There are presets and LUTs already there to choose from to get that right look. You can get some cinematic video looks without being a pro. This is a pretty awesome feature. This is absolutely crazy to me. It blew my mind after seeing it. It won't be a big deal for standard users, but for video creators, being able to shoot in log from stock software is next level. There's also a point zoom feature where you can set a smooth zoom towards a target. It works really well, and I think this phone is a game changer for creators. The only downside is that the features are not available for the wide-angle lens. I really hope to see an update down the road to enable this. The fifth feature is the headphone jack. Yes, most manufacturers are killing it off, but LG is embracing it, making the best audio device that they've ever made. The quad DAC is here, so no matter the headphones you have, everything will sound better, including higher impedance headphones, so audiophiles should be happy with this. The DAC inside is a high-quality 32-bit ESS Saber ES921AP, which is fantastic, so this could basically rival some dedicated media players. The sound is incredible. I've been listening to a lot of music on it for the last few days, and it's like nothing that I've ever heard from a smartphone before. What's also awesome is that premium B&O headphones will come included in the box if you buy a V30. So what do you guys think of the LG V30? Is this the smartphone that you've been waiting for? It checks almost all of the boxes so far. Only thing it's missing is the dual speaker setup. I really wish it had that, but I'm really liking it so far. Battery life has also been solid and promising, but I do need to use this for a few more weeks to come to a final conclusion.